always thanks for watching. Today the topic is amenorrhea. Let's begin.
Amenorrhea, what does it mean? The absence of menstrual flow. Amenorrhea can be classified as primary or secondary. With primary amenorrhea, menstruation fails to begin before age 16. With secondary amenorrhea, it begins at an appropriate age, but later ceases for 3 or more months in the absence of normal physiologic causes, such as pregnancy, lactation, or menopause. Pathologic amenorrhea results from an ovulation or physical obstruction to menstrual outflow, such as from an imperforate hymen, cervical stenosis, or intrauterine adhesions. Actually, an ovulation itself may result from hormonal imbalance, debilitating disease, stress or emotional disturbances, strenuous exercise, malnutrition, obesity, or anatomic abnormalities, such as a congenital absence of the ovaries or uterus. Amenorrhea may also result from drug or hormonal treatments. History and physical examinations. Begin by determining whether the amenorrhea is primary or secondary. If it's primary, ask the patient at what age her mother first menstruated, because age of menarche is fairly consistent in families. Form an overall impression of the patient's physical, mental, and emotional development, because these factors, as well as heredity and climate, may delay menarche until after age 16. If menstruation began at an appropriate age but has since ceased, determine the frequency and duration of the patient's previous menses. Ask her about the onset and nature of any changes in her normal menstrual pattern, and determine the date of her last menses. Find out if she has noticed any related signs, such as breast swelling or weight changes. Determine when the patient last had a physical examination. Review her health history, noting especially any long-term illness, such as anemia, or use hormonal contraceptives. Ask about exercise habits, especially running, and whether she experiences stress on the job or at home. Ask about the patient's eating habits, including the number and size of daily meals and snacks, and ask if she has gained or lost weight recently. Observe her appearance for secondary sex characteristics or signs of virilization. If you are responsible for performing a pelvic examination, check for anatomic aberrations of the outflow tract, such as cervical adhesions or an imperforate hymen. Medical causes of amenorrhea. Adrenal tumor. Amenorrhea may be accompanied by acne, thinning scalp hair, increased blood pressure, truncal obesity, and psychotic personality changes. Asymmetrical ovarian enlargement in conjugation with the rapid onset of virilizing signs is usually indicative of an adrenal tumor. Adrenocortical hyperplasia. Amenorrhea precedes characteristic Cushingoid signs such as truncal obesity, moon face, buffalo hump, bruises, hypertension, renal calculi, psychiatric disturbances, acne, thinning scalp hair typically appear. Amenorrhea lactation disorders such as Forbes-Albright and Chiari-Formel syndromes produce secondary amenorrhea accompanied by lactation in the absence of breastfeeding. Associated features include hot flashes, vaginal atrophy, and large engorged breasts. Congenital absence of the ovaries results in primary amenorrhea and the absence of secondary sex characteristics. Primary amenorrhea occurs with congenital absence of the uterus. The patient may develop breasts. Corpus luteum cysts may cause sudden amenorrhea as well as acute abdominal pain and breast swelling. Examination may reveal vaginal and cervical hyperemia. In addition to amenorrhea, a hypothalamic tumor can cause endocrine and visual field defects, gonadal underdevelopment or dysfunction, and short stature. Ovarian insensitivity to gonadotropins, a hormonal disturbance. Ovarian insensitivity to gonadotropins leads to amenorrhea and an absence of secondary sex characteristics. Uterine hypoplasia. Primary amenorrhea results from underdevelopment of the uterus, which is detectable on physical examination. Other causes of amenorrhea. Surgery. Surgical removal of both ovaries or the uterus produces amenorrhea. Irradiation of the abdomen may destroy the endometrium or ovaries, causing amenorrhea. Drugs. Busulfan, injectable or implanted contraceptives, and clofosfamide may cause amenorrhea. Hormonal contraceptives may cause anovulation and amenorrhea after they are discontinued. Nursing consideration. Nurse must consider in patients with secondary amenorrhea, physical and pelvic examinations, must rule out pregnancy before diagnostic testing begins. Prepare the patient for tests such as progestin withdrawal, serum hormone and thyroid function studies, and endometrial biopsy. Patient teaching. Explain to the patient all tests and procedures. Explain the underlying disorder and treatment plan. Encourage the patient to discuss her fears and, if necessary, refer her for psychological counseling.
I hope that you have benefited from the information, and whoever has any comments, please write it at the bottom of the video on amenorrhea, and I will answer all the questions. Thank you for following up. Have a good day.